Hey guys, welcome back to KUROSU, and today I'm so excited to show you another quick and easy way on how to achieve this authentic x-ray effect using my thermal LUT pack inside of After Effects. So without further ado, let's start editing. The first thing we need to do is right click and go to new and select the adjustment layer. Next, we will want to go search for a few effects we want to include in this tutorial. So let's search for the tint effect and drag that onto the adjustment layer. Next, we will need the invert effect as a visual reference, so let's include that as well. We'll also need the curves effect for adjusting the overall intensity of our edit. Once we've included those effects, we'll want to go and select some of the points inside of curves to make our edit stand out more. You could always come back to the curves to keep readjusting to your liking as we continue on this video. Next, we'll search for the noise effect, apply it, and set the amount to about 20%. After that, go search for Lumetri Color, and under the Creative subpanel, click on Browse. From there, you'll want to navigate where you downloaded my thermal LUT pack, which, by the way, if you haven't already, go check it out on my website. From there, you could download it and receive not just x-ray effects, but over 65 realistic thermography LUTs inspired by real thermal imaging cameras, along with some of my own original thermal looks. I'll provide a link at the top of the description, along with some other editing assets you might enjoy using. I'll also throw in a 20% off discount using the code X-ray20. So once you found my LUTs pack, I recommend looking for the carbon LUT as it gives a pretty authentic x-ray look, and once you apply it, we can now go back to the invert effect and disable it. But we aren't quite done just yet. We'll want to add a nice subtle glow to create the illusion that there is a bit of depth in our footage, so I'll be using the deep glow plugin for this tutorial. After that, bring the radius down to 200 and lower the exposure to about 0.5. Now our footage looks a bit too overexposed, so let's add two brightness and contrast effects. Bring down the brightness for the first effect to negative 80, and then boost both contrasts all the way to 100. And there you have a simple x-ray effect. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, be sure to like and subscribe so that you could stay up to date with future tutorials and new editing assets I'll be releasing very soon. And feel free to check out my current editing assets on my website. The link will also be in the description. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.